Kingdom purpose, kingdom dominion, discipling nations. Whether you realize it or not, you were created to rule God's kingdom on earth. Hello and welcome to the Kingdom Network. I'm Abraham John. It's time to discover your kingdom purpose and calling. That whatever God spoke over His creation is still going on today. Everything is doing exactly the same thing, maybe in the fallen state. Have you ever asked, why is there so much evil happening on this earth? If God is in control of everything, why doesn't He stop evil or from bad things happening to good people? That's a common question we hear from a lot of people. If God is a good God, and if He is almighty, then why all the evil that we see? Wars, sicknesses, poverty, crime, abuse, murder, etc. are happening on the earth, and why doesn't He stop them? People say that because of their lack of understanding of our purpose. Genesis 1:26 says, God said, "Let us create man in our image and likeness, and let them have dominion." Let us take a closer look at that verse. God said, "Let us make man," when He created us. God was included in the creating part of mankind, but when He delegated the dominion part, He did not include Himself. He said, "Let them have dominion." Who is them? He's talking about us, mankind. He gave mankind absolute authority over this earth, and what happens here? That is one of the reasons for all of the evil that is happening around us. We let it happen. Plus, there is an evil one called the devil. He uses people to accomplish his will, even then only if a human allows or to give him permission to do that. And we will discuss this more in detail in another show. When Adam made a choice contrary to God's will, God did not step in to interfere with his choice. God said, "It's up to you. Do you want to partner with me or the devil?" We have the choice. Now the question is, what did God mean when He told mankind to have dominion, and how do we do it in our day and time? That's a good question. I didn't know that because I was so confused about my purpose and my existence on this face of the earth, and I was so depressed, to be honest with you. But thank God for His mercy. You may say that we will reign or we will have dominion only when we come back in the next life. Oh, really? That means the lion is not the king of the jungle anymore. Can you try to tell a lion not to be the king of the jungle? When I was in Kenya, I went to this natural habitat where the wild animals lives, you know, the Maasai Mara. It's an amazing place. I saw lions out there. You know, I tried to tell one of the lion, you know, "You cannot be the king of the jungle." He looked at me like, "You are my lunch in a few minutes." Thank God I was in a protected vehicle. You know, the lion didn't take a break from being a king in the jungle because Adam fell. No, the fish can't swim in the ocean or the bird shouldn't fly. You try to tell that to a bird or to a fish, they will look at you like they won't look at you. They're just doing because they're not waiting for Jesus to come back to do what they were born to do. They're all doing what they were born to do. As I speak, and man is ruling this planet right now, as we notice. Did God change His mind concerning our purpose anywhere in the Bible? I don't think so. I don't read that anywhere. God is a king, and He lives in heaven. His throne is in heaven. He rules over the nations and the universe. He wanted someone to rule the planet Earth on behalf of him and to establish his kingdom on this planet. That is why he created human species. The symbol and the basic definition of dominion is to rule. But we all do not rule the same way. Each one of us fulfills our purpose of dominion a little differently. Make sure to tune in each week as we discover God's kingdom truths. If you have missed any of my teachings, you can watch them and re-watch them at the kingdomnetwork.org website. So make sure you visit that and watch the shows until it became a reality, this truth became a reality in your spirit and in your heart. These are very foundational and powerful teachings. If you do not understand this, we won't understand anything else in the Bible or about our life. There is so much confusion and misunderstanding about the dominion teaching among the body of Christ. People are afraid to mention that word. Can you imagine? Christians are being afraid to say the very word God created us for. It cannot get any more weird than that. No one else is afraid to say that word. The ungodly and the other religious groups are not afraid of that word because they are all doing what God created them to do. Maybe not in every aspect of their life, but at least the ruling part of their life. Everyone except for us. The deception is that great. The devil's plan is to keep us inside the four walls that we call church so he and his children can rule on the earth and no one questions him. I want to declare by faith that time is over in Jesus' name. It's time for God's children to receive the truth, to rediscover our purpose, to rise up in the nations of the world, to execute the will, plan, and the purpose of God that he purposed in Christ Jesus when? Before the foundation of this world. Because we did not understand what God said about dominion, we threw it out of the window. We threw the baby out with the bathwater. We said, no, we don't want to do anything. We're just going to continue our religious thing, what we have been doing, until Jesus comes back and do something. Let me tell you, let's explore the meaning of the word dominion a bit. What does it actually mean, and how does it look like it for us today? The word dominion is a kingdom word. Again, the definition of dominion means to rule. This is the fundamental meaning of dominion. Your number one responsibility is to rule over life on the earth on behalf of God. To have dominion means to rule, to govern, to manage, to master, establish, be fruitful, to restore, work, subdue, overcome, maximize, and cultivate. There are 12 definitions of the word dominion. Each one of us is created to do one or more of these in at least one area of life. And not everyone rules the same way. Everyone is not called to be in government, but everyone rules over something, eventually bringing the entire planet under the rulership of Jesus Christ, our King. That is God's original intent for mankind. How do we do this? First, we start ruling our own life, our emotions, our body, past abuses, whatever happens to us, failures, mistakes, and prejudices. If we do not rule our own life, we will not be able to rule any other aspects of life outside there, because many are waiting to do great things when they are not able to take care of their own life. We have to start the ruling part with our personal life. And if we try to do without ruling our personal life, it will only be temporary and we will be crushed by life's challenges. So one of the meaning of the word dominion means to govern. You might ask, what is the difference between ruling and governing? It's similar to the same difference between a leader and a manager. A ruler is someone who is over a region, the whole country or an organization or an institution, then he will have governors under him to help him rule. In our day and time, an administrator or a secretary would be considered a person who governs. In the Bible days, and even today, it's common to have governors over states or regions. They work under the federal government. So this word dominion is a kingdom word, and it is very key to understand right now because it's connected to our purpose. So we want to encourage you to tune into our future shows, and I'll be going into details explaining the other 11 definitions of the word dominion, because your purpose is connected to one of those definitions of the word dominion, because that is God's eternal purpose for mankind. Do you know the number one challenge of our day and time is the identity crisis? People do not know why they are here. They do not know their purpose. So we have the best tool that you can find on this planet Earth today. We have a wonderful book called Purpose, Calling, and Gifts. Once you discover your purpose, the next step is to discover what you are called to do to fulfill that purpose. And God gave you gifts, natural, spiritual, and motivational, or the skills that you learned in school to fulfill that calling. And this book will change your life and equip you to discover your purpose and fulfill it in this life. So please make sure to go to our website and order it. We will rush this to you as soon as we can. So thank you so much. So I'm just going to pray and bless you for God to open up your spirit man to receive the truth of this word that came from the Lord. Father, I thank you for my viewers watching from around the world. I thank you for your grace. I thank you for your eternal purpose. And you will never change your purpose for mankind and for this planet Earth. I bless them, Father, with the revelation of your purpose and the callings and the gifts that you deposited into their DNA when they were born, and also when they were born again in their spirit man's DNA. I call those gifts to manifest for them to make a difference for God's kingdom on this planet Earth. So thank you, Father, for doing that. I bless you in Jesus Christ's holy name. Amen. I know you will discover your purpose and fulfill your calling and your gifts. So kingdom living is for today, not just in heaven. Don't wait until you die to live in God's kingdom. It is for now. That's where we find our identity, purpose, and passion. I invite you to visit our website, thekingdomnetwork.org, and join us with a monthly giving to help others discover their purpose and disciple nations. Together, we can share the message of the kingdom to every nation and around the world. Join me as I continue this teaching on the 12 definitions of dominion. Remember, though we all have the same purpose, we are not called to fulfill it the same way. It is time to rediscover our kingdom responsibility and rule over life on earth on behalf of God. So thank you so much for watching. I know you're blessed by this word, and the next show will be more powerful. So make sure you tune in next time. Mark your calendar and your time. And until next time, I'm Abraham.